first of all, Alan, how did he survive? How did he survive when this spacecraft disintegrated midair?
It's a really amazing, remarkable story. We still only have sketchy details, but his story is starting to emerge. He says that the spacecraft disintegrated around him. Now, he wasn't wearing a pressure suit, which astronauts and fighter pilots normally wear at these altitudes, which are, you know, 50,000 feet or thereabouts, where the air is 70 degrees below zero, and there's essentially no oxygen, not enough to sustain life. So he's thrust into this environment. Your body remains conscious for perhaps 9 to 12 seconds after being thrust into that thin air. Somehow he managed to unbuckle his seatbelt. He was still attached to his seat. That was very critical because the parachute doesn't work unless you're free of your seat. And then the parachute deployed automatically as he got to lower altitudes.
It's absolutely incredible, especially when you think about the fact that this spacecraft had no escape hatch, right?
It had exit doors, but right, it was designed to withstand to keep the atmosphere constant. It's built with carbon fiber, so it's very resilient structure. But as we know, it didn't survive the early deployment of its braking system, and it did break apart.
Now, what are we learning in terms of his conversations from NTSB investigators? What else are we learning about the cause of the crash and why this happened?
Well, in all these investigations, it's still very early. But what we do know is that this aircraft has a very unique system for reentry that causes it to behave almost like a leaf or a feather. It just sort of floats into the atmosphere, and it does so by moving this giant boom at the rear of the spacecraft into an upward position, almost in a V, like so. Well, that thing came up as they were rocketing into space when it's not supposed to be deployed, and that broke the ship apart. Now, why that happened, there's an awful lot to be done before they determine all the underlying causes.
Exactly. And my next question is, when's the next launch? This particular engine, Richard Branson and Virgin Galactic had a lot of hope for. Do they plan to stick to the plan and just change a few things? What's next?
Well, so far, they're building another spacecraft to replace the one that broke apart. There's no hard dates for testing, but they have said they plan to continue the program. But I think a lot will depend on what the investigation finds. If for example, there are need to be redesigns that could slow things. There's just a lot we don't know at this point.